let's be real, savings accounts suck. Most big banks will offer you rates around 0.01%. And when I Googled best high yield savings accounts, apparently the best rates you can get right now at some smaller banks are only slightly better at 0.5%. So with inflation currently sitting at 5.4% this year, that 0.5% is still doo-doo. But as much as I love investing, I can't invest all our money. So I still need a little cash cushion set aside for emergencies. We're buying a house this year, so we'll need to bump up that emergency savings a little more in case things in our house start breaking. So today I'm gonna discuss my four favorite options for stashing my emergency cash and rank each of these options in four categories: returns, convenience, safety, and tax advantages. So number one, BlockFi, 7.5%. BlockFi is a platform that lets you earn interest on your cryptocurrency. The rates on each cryptocurrency vary, and you can earn interest even if you don't have any cryptocurrency yet. You can trade in your US dollars for stable coins like GUSD, which is pegged in a 1-to-1 ratio with the US dollar. So you won't see those huge ups and downs in GUSD that you would see with other cryptocurrencies. For example, $500 of GUSD should always be $500. GUSD currently earns 7.5% APY on BlockFi. BlockFi is not FDIC insured, but their deposits are held by the Gemini Trust Company. Gemini is a licensed custodian regulated by the New York Department of Financial Services, and they received SOC2 compliance from Deloitte for their custody solution. Gemini keeps 95% of its assets in cold storage, meaning offline, and 5% in hot wallets that are insured by Aon. And BlockFi states that they have never lost any customer funds. We previously did a full review on BlockFi, so check that out after this. Number two, PrizePool, 3.68%. PrizePool is what you would get if your savings account got it on with the Powerball lottery. Every $1 in your balance gets you one ticket per day. For example, if you have $100, you'll earn 100 tickets per day. All of your tickets will automatically be entered into the weekly drawing held every Friday at 12 p.m. Pacific time. There are over 4,000 cash prizes every week, including a $25,000 grand prize in every 4-week series. So whether you win a prize or not, you'll never lose your deposit. It's FDIC insured. And you'll still earn a 0.3% savings bonus. So I've been testing PrizePool for about 7 months, and I'm currently earning 3.68% APY. Yada is a savings account that utilizes the same prize concept as PrizePool. I tested out Yada for about 6 months using the same amount of money that I had in my PrizePool account, but my Yada account only earned 1.55% APY. Graham Stephan and a lot of other big YouTubers have already made Yada pretty popular, so I think it's just oversaturated now. I like PrizePool over Yada because it's still new, so there's fewer people to compete with for prizes. So get in on this one while you can. Actually, please don't, so I can keep getting more of the prizes. Just kidding, kind of. So if you're interested in signing up for PrizePool, use our link in the video comments and we can both earn more. You will get a 10% boost on your winnings, and we will also get a small referral bonus. Number
three.
Betterment Safety Net, 4%. This next option is not necessarily a savings account, but you can definitely use it as one. Betterment is a robo-advisor where you can open several different types of IRAs and taxable accounts. A cool thing you can do with Betterment is create different accounts for different goals. They have an option known as a safety net, which is a taxable account with an asset allocation of 30% stocks, 70% bonds. So this basically utilizes the methodology that if you might need your money soon, you should invest less in stocks and more in bonds, which is what most financial advisors would recommend you do as you get older and closer to retirement. So you can use this same concept to create an emergency savings bucket. By investing in some stocks, you're getting higher returns, but you're also protected from losing a lot of that money if there's some kind of market crash, because the majority of your money is in bonds. I've been using the safety net for about a year and actually have two accounts where I've tested different asset allocations. The 30% stock, 70% bonds allocation earns about 4%, and the 60% stock, 40% bonds allocation earns about 10%. So the goal of the emergency savings is to have cash readily available, not necessarily to earn the highest returns possible, but I couldn't help myself. I had to dabble and tweak it a little just out of curiosity. But even the standard 30-70 safety net allocation earns a very respectable 4%. Another great perk of using a taxable account as your emergency savings is that you'll likely be able to get a better tax rate on your earnings. So I like Betterment because it is one of the first robo-advisors that was out there. They offer low advisory fees of 0.25%. And since the goal here is emergency savings rather than growth, I really just want a very simple and convenient option where I can deposit money and forget about it. If you try to recreate this on your own, you will be spending time rebalancing the account and picking out funds. So this way keeps it easy. I have a link in the video comments for Betterment, and if you use our link, you'll get $5,000 managed for free. All right, let's take a quick break and talk about the tax benefits of this account. First off, in case you didn't know, you have to pay taxes on the interest you earn from your savings account. The interest you earn in a standard savings account is taxed as ordinary income, which means it's taxed at the same rate as your income tax bracket, which could be as high as 37%. However, stocks are taxed as either short-term capital gains or long-term capital gains. So if you hold the stock for less than a year, you will be taxed at the short-term capital gains rate, which is the same as your income tax bracket. But if you hold your stock for longer than a year, you will be taxed at the much more favorable long-term capital gains rate, which could be 0%,
15%, or 20%,
depending on your taxable income. So you could potentially be paying zero taxes on the income from selling your stocks. And some bonds are not taxed at all. So if you don't end up having any kind of emergency for over a year, you can pay a lot less in taxes on those earnings. Number four, Roth IRA. Unlimited. Now we've come to my final and favorite place to store my emergency money, a Roth IRA. So you may be thinking, wait, aren't IRAs for retirement? Well, yes, they were created with the intention to help you save for your retirement, but there are times when you can access that money even if you're not retired. So you can access any money that you contribute to a Roth IRA at any time without worrying about taxes or penalties. You just can't access the earnings. So if you've contributed $20,000 to your Roth IRA and now it's worth $25,000, you can withdraw that $20,000 whenever you want. This rule is a little different if you did an indirect contribution or conversion to get the money into your Roth IRA. If that's the case, you may have to wait at least 5 years from the time you did your conversion. And if you ever have a real major life emergency, there are rules in place that allow you to access the earnings from your Roth IRA without penalties. I won't go over all those specific examples here, but just look up penalty-free IRA withdrawals. Since you can invest in stocks, ETFs, index funds, and other things in a Roth IRA, your interest rate is technically infinite here. So if you invested in Tesla in your Roth IRA and it had 100% returns, congratulations, your savings account is now earning 100%. Peter Thiel, one of the founders of PayPal, was able to turn $2,000 in his Roth IRA into $5 billion, tax-free. So let's put all this information together and rank my four favorite options on returns, convenience, safety, and tax advantages. I'm gonna give each category 1 to 5 stars. So returns are how high the earnings are. Convenience would be how easy it is to qualify for these high rates and how easily you can access your money. So many of the other savings accounts I researched made you jump through all these hoops, you know, direct deposit requirements, minimum monthly transaction requirements, or maybe only allowing you to earn high interest on a small part of your balance. So for example, T-Mobile Money only allows you to earn 4% on the first $3,000 if you're a T-Mobile customer and if you make 10 transactions per month. So this is me and Laura going grocery shopping at 10 p.m. to make 4 more debit card transactions. Not cool. I gave Betterment and the Roth IRA 3 stars because you have to sell your investments to cash out. BlockFi and PrizePool are pretty convenient, but you still have to wait a few days if you're moving cash from these accounts back to your checking account. So I gave them 4 stars. Safety is how well your money is protected. So I gave BlockFi 2 stars because the website does seem very secure and the assets are mostly stored in cold storage, but there's really no guarantee what would happen to your money if the crypto market crashes. PrizePool is the only option here that's FDIC insured, so I gave them a full 5 stars. Betterment, I gave 4 stars because your asset allocation keeps you pretty well protected here. And the Roth IRA is 3 stars because the stock market is safer than the crypto market, but obviously pullbacks and crashes can happen here too. And if you're investing in individual stocks, that's gonna be riskier than investing in index funds. Last is tax advantages. So BlockFi and PrizePool both get 2 stars here because they're still taxed at a better rate than your normal 9-to-5 job since you're not paying Medicare and Social Security tax on these earnings. But Betterment is better because you can pay long-term capital gains. And the Roth IRA is the best because all the earnings made within the Roth IRA are tax-free and nothing beats free. So I tallied up the scores for each. In first place is the Roth IRA. Tied for second place is PrizePool and Betterment Safety Net. And third place goes to BlockFi. Let me know in the comments what other saving account options you've tried and what you liked or didn't like about it. Thanks, and I'll see you for the next Pillow Talk.